Other. So we've added a new route up top, and we've actually added a tunnel underneath as well. So you get a lot of changes coming to the red building, and you see a lot of choke points like these hallways that we're opening up. We're creating new opportunities for the attackers, for the defenders, just redefining the space a little bit more so it's not as claustrophobic.
Yeah, and what I'm hearing is that it's a lot about navigation, a lot about those angles, a lot about those choke points, taking away all the things that are frustrating about these maps, but keeping the good things.
That's it.
Yeah, absolutely. And now a map that's a little bit further down the line, so we don't have a lot to show for it, is Theme Park. But that, you know, our players have a lot of opinions about Theme Park, don't they?
Yeah. It's a little ways away, but we do have a floor plan we want to show. Keeping things that worked, like on the first floor, Drug Lab was great, but then you get the maze that's happening to the side with gargoyles, so we want to kind of streamline that a little bit more and balance the lighting. Right now, Theme Park is a map that's super, super dark in some places, super bright in some places, so kind of averaging it out so that it's easier for players to recognize what's happening. Cool. And then on the second floor, we're actually taking a look at that connecting hallway where you have the train cars. It's very hard to flush out defenders. There's so many hiding spots. And we're also going to be taking a look at the twin staircase there, too.
Yeah, this is really exciting because this is the first time we've ever shown a year four season four map tease in a year four panel, which is really cool to see. So you get a full look at all the stuff that we're working on. And I mean, that's not even all the stuff. That's just the tip of the iceberg of what we're working on. And, you know, when we look at these maps, they're always going to be iterative upon. And I think one of the things that we normally look at when we look at balancing is operators. And that's why I like to bring in Kit Grant.
Ce qu'on espère tous, des joueurs jusqu'à nous en tout cas, c'est d'être, d'agir différemment, d'avoir un meilleur jeu, de pouvoir avoir un jeu en meilleure santé, meilleure qualité, bref, augmenter tous les paramètres du jeu. Et donc la grande transformation que l'on fait, c'est qu'on va fabriquer des équipes dédiées, des brigades qui vont prendre ces sujets majeurs et qui seront là 24 heures sur 24 pour corriger et répondre à ces sujets.
It's an absolute change of fundamentals in how the team operates. There are different cells: event cell, operator cells, a cell about player behavior and handling toxicity, and a playlist cell. The roadmap, the operations are going to cover still the 8 operators, your classic elements that you expect in a season, but more rework. We're putting a dedicated team that's all about the maps and balancing the maps. Work on the choke points, work on the layouts that needs fixing is going to be one of the missions.
Pour cette année 4, on va changer la formule. Une nouvelle map et 3 rework. Améliorer des choses, redonner un cycle de vie aux maps, redonner une nouvelle dynamique.
Le jeu, il est important qu'il soit toujours en recherche de nouveautés. L'événement allie le parfait mélange entre la légèreté d'un événement et en même temps pour moi une phase d'exploration. Donc année 4, nous allons commencer à tabler sur des gameplays, des mécaniques. Nous avons envie de tester, voir les réactions du public, etc. C'est un gage d'avenir aussi pour Siege.
We now have a full production team dedicated to doing that 100% of the time, shipping operator reworks and tweaking the game. We're going to be reworking Lion, Glaz, Ying, Dokebi, Capitao, and that's just the beginning. Many more are to come, we just can't announce them yet.
In the past months, we've set up a cell dedicated to player behavior. That cell will be looking 360 at toxicity, team kill, leaving, all of the negative and positive behavior. They're now going to be tackling the most important feature the game is going to be seeing, that is handling team kill. So I'm extremely happy to announce that in season 1, we'll be seeing in the TTS the first prototype playable by all of the people in test server of the reverse friendly fire, which is a feature that's gonna punish players that are trying to perform a team kill. This is gonna be tremendously changing how you interact with the game and the rest of your players without disrupting the tension and the lethality of the game.
Un jeu multiplayer, c'est massivement des gens qui se déplacent à travers un jeu. Quel est le parcours que je choisis? Est-ce que je vais en casual? Est-ce que je vais en ranked? Ou une autre playlist? Il était important pour nous d'avoir une unité, une brigade qui gère les flots de tous ces joueurs-là. Ces joueurs-là, ils sont différents. Ils sont débutants, ils ont 3 minutes de jeu, comme ils sont pros, ils ont des milliers d'heures de jeu au compteur. Toutes ces populations, on doit les adresser. On ne peut pas les adresser avec égalité. Donc nous avons bâti une cellule qui est dédiée à la régulation de tous ces flots.
The philosophy of the newcomer playlist is really to offer new players a controlled environment, a safer one, where they can focus on learning the core mechanics of Siege and have less amount of content to learn. So smaller amount of maps, just 3 maps, and only one game mode, the bomb game mode. Several things are going to change as well for the casual players. The first one is the long-awaited reduction of the action phase the timer, which is going from 4 minutes to 3 minutes and 30 seconds. And there are two other aspects that are really important. Attackers are going to be able to choose their spawn points freely, like they already do in the ranked playlist. And defenders will be informed of which sides they are going to defend, which will allow them to select an operator that is adapted to the sides they are going to defend.
We have been dreaming about that moment when we can remove the beta tag in ranked. In the first half of the year, that beta tag will be removed. The playlist initiative and cell is hard at working on introducing pick and ban as the main game mode for ranked, starting season 2 of year 4. Finally, we're like so glad that we can bring that awesome piece of gameplay, of tactic, of choice that pick and ban is in ranked. We have 4 major events that are going to be across the world, starting with Europe, and we're going to go in Italy in May. Next major this summer in August will be in North America, but I can't reveal the location. Finally, we'll go to Asia for the first time in November and back in Montreal for Six Invitational 2020.
2019, quatrième année, beaucoup de transformations que l'on fait sur nous. Il y a une forme de continuité, quatrième année, et en même temps de début assez fort. En fait, je vis cette année, ce 2019, avec énormément d'excitation. J'ai une fin incroyable de ces transformations que l'on fait et des résultats qui vont donner à notre jeu et à notre communauté.